Hello, my dear children. Today we are going to do the second story in the 9th standard supplementary reader, The Adventures of Toto. This story is written by Ruskin Bond. You all know Ruskin Bond. He's no stranger to us. Already we have done his lesson last year in the Monsoon Diary. Okay. And apart from that, he is a popular writer of stories. He's published many short stories as well as novels, and in 7th standard also we had to study a story by him, so we are familiar with the author. So we can go into the story now, The Adventures of Toto. We already know that the author's grandfather had the habit of collecting animals. You know, he used to get animals from different sources. Actually, there's a book itself, Grandfather's Private Zoo by Ruskin Bond. It's very interesting to read it because of the variety of pets he has and how he takes care of them. All this, it's very interesting. So if you ever get it somewhere, please do read it. Now, grandfather got Toto from a Tonga driver, and he pays 5 rupees for him. Actually, at that time, 5 rupees was a big amount, was a huge sum. And the Tonga driver, he actually must have got the monkey from somewhere, so he used to keep it tied up to a feeding trough. Because he didn't know what else to do with the monkey, otherwise the monkey will go away, isn't it? And grandfather felt that the monkey is so cute, so nice, and why is it tied up to this? He didn't like it. He felt it doesn't look good, that it's not its natural environment. And so he bought it from the Tonga. And he looks very nice, very pretty. He has nice bright eyes with sparkle. And when you see the sparkling itself, we can know he's very mischievous also. And he has eyes, deep set eyes, pretty eyes. His teeth are white, pearly white. And he often smiles. And the way he smiles, but ladies get scared because, you know, it seems a bit frightening also. That way he'll smile. Though his face is very nice, his hands look very dried up, you know, as though it has been pickled. You know, mango season is just over. You must have seen how people, they put out mango or anything else for drying, and when it dries, how the entire thing becomes wrinkled. That's how his hand looks. But his fingers, they are very quick and wicked. They can do anything very fast, and he has a beautiful tail, long tail. And he uses this tail in a very handy manner. He uses it as a third hand. He uses it to hang from a branch. If he sees there is some delicacy, some very tasty dish, you know, which he can't reach with his hands, he will use his long tail and take it off without anybody seeing it. And we'll not imagine that he will use his tail to take away this dish, you know. So he will use it to steal also. So he was a very cunning, good-looking monkey. And whenever grandfather bought a new pet, grandmother used to create a big fuss because she was fed up of all these pets. So they didn't want to tell grandmother immediately. They thought, we'll keep it a secret. When she's in a good mood, we'll tell her we've got a new monkey. So where do we keep this? So in his room, there's a wardrobe kind of place. So they decided they'll keep it inside that. They'll tie it to a peg. And when they were tying it, they thought, okay, this is very safe, the monkey will go anyway. After some time, you know, they felt the monkey has been inside there for quite some time, let us release it. So we went there and we found that the wall, till then it had nice paper had been kept on it. Now all that paper has been removed, and you can just see brick and plaster left there. And the peg which had been there, that has been pulled off from the socket. And his school uniform, which was there, is completely torn. And I thought that, okay, now grandfather will be upset and all. But grandfather is very happy. He's saying, oh, such a clever monkey, you know. He had left it for some more time. He would have taken all your clothes. He would have made it into a rope. And he would have escaped through the window. So he's a completely intelligent fellow. He's a clever. Anyway, still his presence in the house is a secret. So now where do we keep him? So they took him to the servant's quarter. There is a big cage in which some animals are living together very happily. They are different animals, but they are all very happy. They decided to keep the monkey there. But this monkey doesn't adjust with anyone. He didn't allow any of his companions to sleep. So grandfather decided, okay, tomorrow I'm going to Saharanpur. I will take him along with me. I can't keep him in the house. You can't keep it inside a cupboard. You can't keep him with these animals. If you look at the animals, see the tortoise, the squirrel, the hare, the goat, all of them actually very nice people, very companionably ill. Well, they're living, they're very good people, but Toto cannot get along with anyone. So in how do you take him to Saharanpur? You can't take him like you're taking any other person. It's an animal, isn't it? So the author could not go with grandfather, but later grandfather narrated what happened. The grandfather took a big bag. Inside that he kept some straw in the end. Straw, you know, like dried hay. And it was kept underneath. And this became his new abode. Abode is place of residence. And Toto was kept inside it. The bag was closed tightly. Now Toto tries to open the bag. He is not able to open. So in his efforts to open the bag, what happened is the bag is falling over, it's turning this side, that side, the bag is jumping. So all are looking at it, what is this, what has happened, why is this bag jumping about? But the bag was able to hold itself and Toto would remain inside the bag. But when they reach Saharanpur, when grandfather, you know, he has to go out of the station, so he's showing the ticket collector the ticket. That time the monkey put its head out and he nicely smiled at the man who's collecting tickets. Now that man was surprised, and what is this? Suddenly the bag is opening, a face is coming out. But he acted as if he's very calm and said, "See, you have a dog with you, you have to pay for it." Grandfather argued, "See, it's not a dog, you can't make me pay for it." But the ticket collector was very stubborn, "You have to pay for the dog." And so he had to pay. Because actually the ticket collector must have thought that he is also a quadruple, four-legged animal. So because he's a quadruple, I'll ask him to pay for it. Then grandfather got very angry. He thought, okay, I'll take revenge. He looked at the tortoise in his pocket. There is a small baby tortoise. He took the tortoise and asked, okay, how much should I pay for this? Then the ticket collector is acting as if he's looking at the tortoise. And he's saying, no, don't charge for this. This is not a dog. You can take it for free. Anyway, at last somehow grandmother accepted Toto and his presence became an open secret. Everyone in the family knew. Okay, where do we keep him? So they thought, okay, now in the stable we have only the donkey Nana, let us take him there. And at night grandfather just went there to see what is happening, he's safe. And he found that without any reason Nana is going on pulling at her halter, she's trying to escape. And she's moving away from hay. Usually animal will go towards hay, but she is going away from hay. So grandfather thought, what happened to her? And he just gave her a hit. And then she moved ahead. And when she moved ahead, he saw that Toto was, hanging on to her long ears with the sharp teeth. So poor thing, it's paining for her. So because when he saw those long ears, he saw naughty and you can say even a bit cruel probably. He just thought, okay, I'll just see how it is. And he bit onto it, and Toto and Nana could never be friends. Now one favorite activity of Toto is to take bath. If you give him warm water, he'll first test the temperature of the water with his hand, then he'll jump, get into it, first one foot, then the other, and then he will, because if you jump into the water, all the water will splash, isn't it? And then he will slowly sit till he's up to his neck in water. Once he becomes comfortable, he'll take soap and he'll start taking bath and all that. And when water becomes cold, he'll start shivering. It's Dehradun, so it's quite cold. So he will run out and he'll go near the kitchen fire to dry himself. And suppose you laugh at him, he will feel very offended. He doesn't like it. Okay. Someone laughs, okay, when he's going to take the bath, he will refuse to go on with his bath. He will say, okay, I won't take bath. That kind of a thing. And he has learned how to take bath by looking at the other, by keenly observing the. Because of this tendency to take bath, one day what happened is they had kept some water on the kitchen to boil, to prepare tea. Toto went there. When he saw hot water, he thought, okay, I'll take bath. He got into it. Water is becoming hot. When he feels the water is becoming too hot, slowly he'll put his head out. But outside it's very cold. Then he thinks, okay, I can't bear the cold. He'll go back into the hot water. And this continued for some time, and luckily grandmother came there. When grandmother came there, she soon took him out of the kettle. Otherwise he would have been boiled alive. He's already, the writer makes fun and says boiled. But the problem with Toto was he's very, very naughty. If there is a part of the brain developed devoted totally to mischief, that part is highly developed in Toto. He will always tear things to pieces. Like one of their aunts come, he will try to tear the dress and make a hole in it. He enjoys troubling people. So one day a wonderful dish of pulao was made, and grandmother had kept it nicely in the center of the dining table. She wanted to attract the children, people at home. And when they went to the room, what they found was he's sitting there and eating it. Grandmother screamed, all effort is gone to waste. And Toto got angry, he threw a plate at her. So one of the aunts, what she did, she rushed forward to rescue the dish, and he poured water in her face. When grandfather came, he knew he could not escape with such tricks, so he took the entire dish of pulao and he escaped through the window. They tried to follow him and they found that he's sitting on a jackfruit tree. The dish is still with him. And he purposely, they're looking at him, he's slowly sitting and eating the entire pulao. Each and every grain, not a single grain of the pulao was left. He ate the entire thing. And then he thought, okay, this lady came and tried to stop me from eating, now I'll also trouble her. That kind of an attitude he had. Okay, you shouted at me, so I'll do something. He threw the dish down from there and it broke into 100 pieces and he started laughing. So obviously they understood Toto is not a kind of pet we can keep with us because he's not getting along with any of the animals. He's destroying everything. He's destroying vessels. He's destroying food. He's destroying curtains, clothes, wallpaper, everything. And they are not so rich that they can go on effort to lose things. So grandfather again went to the Tonga driver and he said, "You please take back Toto." And he sold him for only 3 rupees. Why is it three? Only three? Because he had bought him for 5 rupees and he sells him for 3 rupees. So he has a loss. But that's okay. Here you're losing only 2 rupees. But if you have Toto with you, you're going to lose money. So here some word meanings are there. That's what's that gain there, because that's a kind of place where grandfather goes in Saharanpur. That's where that word comes, halter. That is the rope that is tied around the Nana's neck. And fasten, the word fasten means you're familiar with the word fasten, your seat belts and all that. But often when we get it in another context, we don't think of its meaning, something that's secure. So I hope all of you enjoyed the story of Toto and loved it a lot. There are many more wonderful stories written by Ruskin Bond. Please try to read his books, or maybe a book about Grandfather's Little Zoo. Or if you don't get it, the book as such, search for it online and enjoy reading the stories. Goodbye.